Apostrophe. Possess.
Grammar on the track.
Apostrophes. Omit.
This is my philosophy about apostrophes and the two ways to use them properly. You can possess or omit, but whatever you choose, you gotta own it.
Hey, what does omission mean? And how does it connect to an apostrophe? I'll explain. If you want to change two or more words into one, you got to take out some letters. Now you're doing great, but the mission isn't finished until you've replaced what you've erased with an apostrophe, filling that space. You made a new word and contractions its name. Example, you are a star, becomes you're a star. Example two, I am your teacher, becomes I'm your teacher. Get it? Okay. Let's continue this lesson. The next thing we're learning about is possession.
Hold on.
Can you tell me what that means?
It means
when you possess something, that means you own it. And now that you claimed it, you got to show
again.
It. When you possess something, that means you own it. And now that you claimed it, you got to show it.
Stop. Freeze, 3, 2, 1, go! Now mark your apostrophe after the owner or owners to show your reader what they're owning. Example,
MC, grammar's voice. Teaching English will always be the kid's choice.
Example, 2,
MC grammar's crew will forever be the people's favorite. You know it's true.
That was the commentary. Yeah, there's no stopping me. Here comes the chorus. Sing along
this
with
is
me.
My philosophy about apostrophes and the two ways to use them properly. You can possess or omit. Whatever you choose, you gotta own it. This is my philosophy about apostrophes and the two ways to use them properly. You can possess or omit, but whatever you choose, you gotta own it.